I'm going to the beach. Do you like going to the beach? Me too. Ouch! What was that? I think it came from the ocean. Do you know where the ocean is? Good! I wonder what could be happening down there that could make this whole beach shake. I have an idea! Let's take a journey to the bottom of the ocean and see for ourselves what goes on down there! Ready? Let's go!
That is the ocean floor. When I was just a boy, I was passed on the secrets of this amazing part of the earth, and today I will share them with you. We shall start with the great Alfred Wegener. Alfred Wegener was the original man who came up with the idea of continental drift, the theory that all the continents used to be connected in a single landmass. However, with no solid proof of how the continents could plow through the Earth's surface on their own, his theory was harshly rejected. However, maybe something else could explain how the landmasses had once been joined. That brings us to Harry Hess. He was a geologist and Navy submarine commander during World War II. Part of his mission had been to study the deepest parts of the ocean floor. In 1946, he had discovered that hundreds of flat-topped mountains, perhaps sunken islands, shaped the Pacific floor. After much thought, he proposed in 1960 that the movement of the continents was a result of seafloor spreading. It was possible, he said, that molten magma from beneath the Earth's crust could ooze up between the plates in the Great Global Rift. As this hot magma cooled in the ocean water, it would expand and push the plates on either side of it, North and South America to the west, and Eurasia and Africa to the east. This way, the Atlantic Ocean would get wider, but the coastlines of the landmasses would not change dramatically. Hess proved Wegener's basic idea right, and clarified the process that broke the once-joined continents into the seven with which we are familiar now. The continents are attached to the plates and do not move independently of them, but the plates themselves shift and change shape, carrying the continents along. This is seafloor spreading. But what's the evidence? How do we know this is actually real? Well, by the mid-1960s, studies of the Earth's magnetic field showed a history of periodic reversals in polarity. This means that Earth's magnetic north became south, and north became the new magnetic south. But these kept changing back and forth. So a timescale for normal and reversed polarity was established, showing 171 magnetic flip-flops in the past 76 million years. Magnetic surveys conducted near the mid-ocean ridges showed long patterns of normal and reversed polarity of the ocean floor in bands paralleling the rift and symmetrically distributed as mirror images on either side of it. This proved that the ocean floor was a mix of older and newer crust, and the newer crust was always right by the mid-ocean ridges. Second, the rock making up the ocean floor is considerably younger than the continents, with no samples found over 200 million years old, as contrasted with maximum ages of over 3 billion years for the continental rocks. This confirms that older ocean crust has been reabsorbed in ocean trench systems by subduction, another major part of seafloor spreading. Subduction also helps us prove why the Earth doesn't get any bigger if seafloor spreading is really happening. When the crust gets so old and is pushed so far away, it gets denser and begins to sink back into the ground to be reused again. Also, there is much thinner sediment cover on the newer crust than the older, showing that crust near the ridge hasn't been around as long and hasn't picked up as much sediment. So if that's seafloor spreading, how does it affect our lives? Well, without it, all of the continents would still be connected. There would be no America and no oceans between the continents. Basically, all of the world's land would just be one big island. Since we do have seafloor spreading, though, the continents are still on the move. This means that one day we will crash into each other again, and the world will be much different than it is today. Also, if you jump thousands of miles away from mid-ocean ridges, you'll see the older oceanic crust that was pushed away from them being subducted under continental crust. One thing that can happen when the crust sinks back down, or is subducted, is that it gets heated up by the inner Earth and rises back up again. This pushes the crust on the surface up and forms volcanoes or island arcs. These can affect the lives of people by becoming tourist attractions and bringing tourists to their location, which could help their local economy. Volcanoes could negatively affect people by destroying their homes or even killing them. It sounds crazy, but it's all in the theory of seafloor spreading.
Wow! I really learned a lot down there! Did you learn a lot?